Tonight's Talk at 10. Could today's raids on head shops be the first step in combating the spread of bath salts? Actually, not the first step, but a critical step. And other synthetic drugs throughout central New York and upstate New York, even the whole country. A series of DEA stings across the nation are sending a message out to businesses to stop the sale of the drugs. It's not going to be tolerated or allowed now that there is a growing body of law saying the substances are illegal. The law had been trailing behind reality for quite a while, long enough for bath salts and synthetic drugs in general to get a pretty good running start. Michael Benny joins us tonight for the Talk at 10, as he does every night. And this was another step, but a powerful step. You know, the first big raid since the president signed the law about a month ago saying that bath salts and synthetic drugs in general are illegal to sell, possess, all of that.
Yeah,
it's a big step.
Yeah, and independent of whatever happens legally to these people who are running these head shops, much less the drugs that were seized today, this is the first time that I think the community at large, and we saw it today in Fulton, was sort of cheering as if we had crossed a threshold in this battle on this, this scourge that has plagued central New York almost, at least to a degree, that other communities are not seeing, where we have dozens of shops raided just here in our backyard alone. This was the first time that I think the community sort of turned the corner on this. We saw law enforcement out in force. In some places, they had, they had their heavy weapons with them.
Yeah, I guess they didn't know what they might be presented
what
with.
What they might encounter,
although
yeah.
we do not have any reports of any major resistance or certainly any violence at any of these places. They tend to be kind of laid back in these stores.
But, you know, in the court of public opinion, this is the first step in the tide turning, I think.
Yeah, well, let's listen to a couple of people who live nearby and saw this happening today.
There's a lot of traffic in and out. A lot of kids hang out there. It's sad. It's an epidemic. It needed to be done a long time ago.
I think it's great. They should have done this a long time ago.
A common theme, although a long time ago, I guess, is a relevant phrase, whether we're talking maybe...
Well, we're feeling it more acutely here.
Yes, you know what I mean? So it may have been months or even a couple of years if you broaden the reach of synthetic drugs like salvia and other synthetic marijuana instead of bath salts. I think it was also interesting once we were able to dig into the detail of some of the search warrants that provided the basis, the foundation for this today, to learn more about how this is getting to our community. You know, in these documents, which were largely affidavits put together by some of the key investigators in our region, local people out of the Onondaga County Sheriff's Department, saying that bath salts are coming from China and India. In one case, they say in these documents that they presented to the federal court that they then went to a place in Arizona. Then a couple of packages were shipped to Rochester, to the home of the owner of the 420 Emporium, which is several different stores in Fulton, Syracuse, and a few in Western New York, who so far, as far as I know, is not charged with any crime, by the way, I should add that. But just the track of from here to there, and the $23,000 cash on delivery needed for the FedEx guy to drop off the box.
To drop off the package of synthetic drugs. That was the one fact in all of this that really floored me, to find out that there's that much money involved.
Well, yes.
You know, it certainly gives you a window into why this stuff is still being sold at these places.
And
because
just as
there's a ton of cash
exactly,
to be made off
just
it.
As we've learned traditionally with other white powders like cocaine and heroin, this is being cut down along the way, too. So that package that may have made its way from China and India then went to Arizona, got chopped up a little bit, gets sent here.
Everybody's getting paid.
They add in a couple of chemicals that are maybe not quite as strong or intense, but still make it look good. And so that $23,000 that went to Arizona then has some multiple, maybe, I don't know, three or four times that in terms of the street value when they sell it, wherever they sell it from.
And then there's the trickle down. There's the fact that there are people in our community, and obviously, as we learned today, all over the country, in pockets of the country, as far away as Texas, Florida, in Pennsylvania, and beyond, where this is being felt in real families by real people. I talked to a woman today. She didn't want to share her story with us, but I will share this without revealing who she is.
Right.
She wanted us to do a story in her community because she has family members who are on this stuff. She's worried about them, and she knows that it's being sold at a head shop, you know, not far from where she lives. That place was not targeted today. We have no